Hey, what is going on, Pokemaniacs? Welcome back to a brand new video, and this is actually a special video because I will be making two announcements. Number one is that the last draft that I was doing, I did not make it to the playoffs, so my opponent for week 7 was just a bit too strong, and so was the opponent for the last week. And I just really needed to win the last match, but I just couldn't pull it off. My opponent just outplayed me everywhere. And I've been really sick the last week also, so I couldn't record the battle. So I do apologize for that. Perhaps you guys were looking forward to the end of the regular season on the NBBL Academy, but I just couldn't pull it off, guys. But announcement number two is that a brand new league is starting. And I'm actually very excited because, so if you guys remember, the first draft league that I joined was the Pokémon Ultra Draft League, or Puddle for short. So that was the first one, and it's no longer called Puddle. They rebranded the entire league, and now it's called the Spear Pillar Draft Association. And so yeah, we're gonna be taking part in that league. So it's the same commissioner, you know, the same people managing the league. They just changed the name. And I was fortunate enough to be invited back into the league. So yeah, in this video, I'm gonna be introducing to you guys my new draft team, which I think it's really good. I drafted one Terra Captain that I really wanted to try, so I'm very excited for that. I will also be making a tier list of my opponent's teams. I will also be announcing the 8 other teams that I will be facing throughout the next 2 months. And so yeah, guys, so let's see. Oh, and by the way, I will no longer be the Cerulean City Hurricanes. I decided to represent the city where I'm from, and here it is, guys. Yep, that's right. For this league, I will be the El Paso Pokemon Club. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the battle. Let's go ahead and jump into the draft. Alrighty then, guys. So for the first pick of the El Paso Pokemon Club, we chose the Ursaluna Blood Moon. And let's go ahead and first talk about the abilities, the moves, and then the stats of this Pokemon, shall we? Now, for the abilities, so it has the Mind's Eye, and it basically allows my Ursaluna to hit ghost types with normal and fighting type moves. It will also ignore the evasion like boost that my opponent's Pokemon might have. And now for the stats. So the Ursaluna Blood Moon has an HP of 113, an attack of 70, a really good defense of 120, a special attack of, check this out, 135. That is very powerful, guys. Special defense of 65 and a speed of only 52. But with that HP and that defense, my Ursaluna should be able to take quite a few hits in a comfortable fashion. And now for the attacks. So obviously I'm gonna be packing special attacks with my Ursaluna Blood Moon. The first one is gonna be its signature move, being the actual Blood Moon. That's what the attack it's called. And so it has a power of 140 and an accuracy of 100. So that's really powerful. The only negative thing this move has is that it cannot be used twice in a row, which is not that bad. Now, for the second move, I'm gonna put the Earth Power, because, you know, it's basically the secondary stab move of Ursaluna Blood Moon. For the third one, I'm gonna go for the Vacuum Wave, because I feel like it can be really good, because it provides, you know, that priority move that might just be enough to get the knockout on a Pokemon. Now, for the fourth and final move, depending on the opponent for the week, I will be using the Calm Mind or perhaps the Substitute, which can be really powerful in the right moment. And for the item, I think the only item that I will be using on Ursaluna Blood Moon will actually be the leftovers for sure. So yeah, guys, that's it for the first draft. So let's go ahead and jump into the second one. Additionally, this bad boy is gonna... So for the draft, we have 120 points to draft. Now, this bad boy is gonna set me back 18 points. Okay, guys. Now, for the second draft of the El Paso Pokemon Club, we choose none other than Enamorus Incarnate. Now, Enamorus has two abilities that can be useful in certain scenarios. So, first ability is the Cute Charm, you know, which has a 30% chance of basically seducing the opposite Pokemon. And I think it has to make contact. Actually, I know it has to make contact. And the Pokemon has to be from the opposite gender. Now, this is a legendary, so I don't know if it will apply to all the genders or not. But regardless, I think this, and then the other ability, which I think it's pretty useless, the Contrary. I mean, it can be good. For example, like if my opponent is gonna use an ability that's gonna reduce my stats, Contrary will make, well, the Contrary, instead of reducing my stats, it will increase my stats. And so some of the moves that I'm thinking about with Enamorus is the number one, the Moonblast. Number two, the Earth Power. Number three, the Mystical Fire. And for the last one, we'll have the Healing Wish. So Healing Wish will be like a surprise to some of my opponents, I hope. So the user will faint, but the Pokemon that takes its place will be fully healed to include any status changes. So that is pretty powerful. I'm thinking about using a Choice Scarf or perhaps an Assault Vest and remove the Healing Wish. But we'll see. I think most of the time I really want to bring this guy with the Choice Scarf. But we'll see, guys. Now for the stats. So the Enamorus has 74 HP for the attack, has a really good 115, not bad at all. The special attack has a really powerful 135, the same as Ursaluna, that's OP. But the difference is that Enamorus has a very high speed of 106. Now, that is really good in my opinion. Now, this bad boy right here is gonna send me back 17 points. And with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into pick number three. Alrighty then, for our next pick, we have the Hisuian Samurott. Now, I gotta be honest, the Hisuian Samurott is not a Pokemon that I wanted to draft from the beginning. I know, I'm sorry, Samurott, but I gotta be honest here, I'm a very honest person. Now, the Pokemon that I wanted to draft was Quackaval, but he was taken, and if it was not Quackaval, I really wanted to take the Ogre Pond Water, but he was also taken on a wheel draft, so I have to settle with Hisuian Samurott, which, he is a really good Pokemon, especially, in the beginning of the battle. But we'll see what we can do with this bad boy. Now, let's go ahead and talk about him. Now, Hisuian Samurott has two abilities, the first one being the, the typical turret for the starter Pokemons of the water type, and it has the sharpness, which increases the power of any slicing moves, like its signature one, the Sizzler's Edge. It will increase it by 1.5, which is pretty good, because instead of doing the 65 base power on the Sizzler's Edge, it will do about 90. So yeah, I think actually make it 95. Yeah, so that's pretty good. That's definitely pretty good. That's a good ability. Now for the stats, for HP it has 90, the attack 108, defense 80, special attack 100, special defense 65, and for the speed 85. Now, this might not be really high stats, but they're well-rounded, and I'm actually okay with a well-rounded Pokemon. Now, for the attacks, I think obviously move number one will be the Sizzler's Edge. Number two will either be the Aqua Cutter or the Razor Shell. We'll see, depending on what I need. Number two will be the Aqua Jet or the Sucker Punch. And for the number four move, I'm thinking an Encore for a surprise move or a knockoff. We'll see. I might go for an Aqua Jet and then knockoff and Encore, but who knows. Alright, and that's pretty much it for the Hisuian Samurott, and this guy is gonna set me back 16 points. Okay, and now for the fourth pick of the El Paso Pokemon Club. For the fourth pick, I think we're gonna go for a fan favorite, none other than the Dragonite. Now, Dragonite has only one useful ability, in my opinion, the multi-scale. So whenever Dragonite has full HP, the first attack will do half the damage. So that is pretty good. It can help us set up a Dragon Dance and potentially do a sweep late game. Now the stats of Dragonite are 91 for HP, attack 134. Wow, that is very high, guys. For defense, he has 95, special attack 100, special defense 100, and speed 80, which is the lowest one, but that's okay because we can increase the speed with the Dragon Dance. I'm okay with that. Now for the moves, obviously we're gonna bring the Dragon Dance and the extreme speed, hands down, no question there. For the third move, we might bring so the rest of the moves depend on what my opponent's team is. I can bring the Dragon Claw if I see that my opponent has Dragon type moves. I'm sorry, Dragon type Pokemon. But if I don't see any Dragon type Pokemon, then I will be using perhaps Fire Punch or Earthquake for the third move. And for the fourth move, I might think about using the Roost, perhaps Encore, or Ice Spinner and Fire Punch. We'll see. Now, this bad boy will set me back 15 points. Okie dokie, guys. For the pick number 5, we chose the Tentacruel. Now, Tentacruel is a Pokemon that I think covers the weaknesses of the Ursaluna Blood Moon pretty well. And the Tentacruel has three abilities. Let's see. So it has the Clear Body, which prevents its stats from being lowered. It has the Ring Dish, which will basically, you know, recover some HP with the rain. And I think the most useful one in certain cases, it's the Liquid Ooze. So it says this Pokemon damages those draining HP from it for as much as they would heal. So for example, if somebody does, let's say, a Giga Drain, instead of healing, it's gonna hurt them. So yeah, that's the ability. Now for the for the stats, it has 80 for HP. For the attack, it has 70. For the defense, has 65. For special attack, 80. And then for the special defense, it has a really good 120. Now that is amazing special defense. And for the speed, it has 100, which is not that bad. Now for the moves, I think I will be using, obviously, number one, the rapid spin. The flip turn for the number 2, move number 3 is going to be the knockoff, and then move number 4 will depend. I might go for the toxic if I know that my opponent will bring a Pokemon that, you know, typically has a sword stance or a dragon dance, I will bring the haze. And then for the items, I think I'm going to give it a heavy duty boots or a leftovers. Now this boy is gonna set me back a really, really high 12 points. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the sixth pick. Okie dokie, guys. Here we are for the pick number 6. We picked the useful Kilowattrol. I think that's how you pronounce that name. Now, I gotta be honest, I copied this Pokemon from Nova, so yep, Nova, thumbs up to you, salutations. I admit it, I'm copying this Pokemon, and I'm actually gonna name him Nova. Now, Nova here has three very useful abilities. So the first one, he has the wind power. So whenever Tailwind is up, or whenever I get hit with a wind move, the next move that I do that's an electric type, it's gonna be stronger. So that's what this ability does. Now if I do set up Tailwind with this own Nova, I'm just gonna call it Nova because I cannot pronounce its name. If Nova sets up the Tailwind, that means that the rest of the electric type moves are just gonna be power up. Now that is very powerful. Now the second ability is the Volt Absorb. So when if the Nova gets hit with an electric type moves, it won't cause any damage. On the other hand, it's gonna heal up. Now that is really good. And for the third and final ability, it has the competitive. So whenever one of my stats is lowered, the special attack is gonna increase by 2 stages. Now that is very powerful. And for the, let's see, for the stats, we have 70 HP, 70 attack, 60 for the defense. Special attack, it has 105, which is not that bad. The special defense, 60. But for the speed, it has 125. This guy is going to be my fastest Pokemon this season. Now, that is really good. Now, for the moves, he's going to have the Thunderbolt, the Hurricane, the Roost, and the U-Turn, or the Volt Switch, depending on what my opponent has on his team. If I know that he's going to be bringing a ground type, then I will have the U-Turn. But if not, the Volt Switch it is. And for the item, it's going to be the Heavy Duty Boots. No other choice. Now, the Nova is going to cost me 10 points. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump to the next pick. Okay, guys. So, for the pick number 7 of the El Paso Pokemon Club, we choose the Revavroom. Revavroom. Well, whatever, the engine. I'm just gonna call him the engine. Now, this engine, it is a Pokemon that I was honestly, like, it never crossed my mind to draft the engine. So basically by this point, most of the Pokemon that I wanted were already drafted, so I had 9 points to spare, and I really needed a Pokemon that could, you know, be a surprise. And I thought, okay, I'm gonna give the engine a try. And so let's go over the abilities of this engine. Now, ability number 1 is the Overcoat, which will prevent damage from sandstorms. Spores won't do anything to Overcoat users. And let's see. Yeah, I think that's about it. And the second ability is the Filter. Now, that is a really good ability. So it says, this Pokemon receives 3/4 of the damage from super effective attacks. Now, for a steel type, that's pretty good. Now, this guy has a typing of steel and poison, which means that any ground type moves will just KO me for sure, and that means that the only item I can have on him is the air balloon. Now, for the stats, so check this out. It has 80 HP, which is not bad. Really good attack of 119, defense of 90, special attack of 54, special defense of 67, and a decent speed of 90. Now, the attack and the speed are the two highest stats, and that means that for the move number 1, I'm gonna be using the shift gear, which increases my speed by 2 stages and my attack by 1. That's really good, and that's gonna make the next 3 moves really powerful. Move number 2 is gonna be the Gunk Shot, which does 120 base power, so that's really good, 120. But the only negative thing is the 80% accuracy, so that means that 1 in 5 will just fail. The move number 3 is going to be the High Horsepower, which is going to give me a really powerful ground type move. And for the 4th move and the 2nd stab, it's going to be obviously the Iron Head. Now, the engine is going to cost me 9 points. Now, let's go ahead and jump into the next pick. Okay, guys, so for the pick number 8 of the El Paso Pokemon Club, it's going to be a Pokemon that, I gotta be honest, I did not want to draft. I know, Sandslash, I'm sorry, but I gotta be honest. Now, the only reason why I drafted the Alolan Sandslash is because originally I wanted a Fortress, but it was taken very early in the draft. But then I realized that I had quite a few Pokemon that were weak to ice. And as I was looking for alternates to the Fortress, I noticed that obviously the Alolan Sandslash, being an ice and steel type, he resists the ice type times 0.25. Yeah. 0.25, and he learns the learns the knockoff and the rapid spin. So I think he covers some of the moves that are normally used with a Fortress. Alrighty then, let's go over the abilities for the Alolan Sandslash. So the first one is the Snow Cloak, which raises the evasiveness by 1.25 in a snowstorm. So it's an okay ability, I guess. And then the second ability is the Slush Rush, which increases the, it doubles the speed in a snowstorm. So I think that's the best ability. Now for the stats, the Sandslash has 75 HP, 100 attack, 120 for the defense, special attack of 25, special defense of 65, and speed of 65. But that's okay because we only want him for the defense and the HP. So the Sandslash is going to be taking a role of a defender. Now for the moves, I'm going to be, obviously, like I mentioned, going to be using the rapid spin for sure. The knockoff for sure as well. For the move number 3, I'm going to be using either the Stealth Rock or the Spikes. And for the last move, I'm thinking the Triple Axel or the Ice Spinner, whichever one I think it's best against my opponent's team. Now for the, let's see, for the item, I might use the Leftovers or the Heavy Duty Boots. That way I can just, you know, come in and then do a rapid spin safely. And the Sandslash is gonna cost me 7 points, leaving me with 16 points left. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the next drafted Pokemon. Okay, guys, now for the pick number 9 of the team, I chose to go for none other than the Golurk. Now, this, so from all the Pokemon in my entire team, Golurk was actually the one that I really want it. I think Golurk has some really good potential now with the Terra battle gimmick. You know, I can choose go into any other typing, which I think can be really useful for Golurk. And I don't know, I think he's like definitely one of my favorite Pokemon overall. And yeah. So I really wanted to use, and by the way, this is going to be a Terra Captain for sure. So yeah, I'm really excited to try this guy out. Now I'm only going to be talking about two abilities that, we're just going to go over all three abilities that Golurk has. The first one is the Iron Fist, which can be really useful. So it will increase the damage on moves such as, you know, for example, Sucker Punch, Fire Punch, Shadow Punch, any punching move, it will increase the base power. The second one, it's the Klutz ability. And what that does, it says this Pokemon's health item has no effect except Macho Brace. Fling cannot be used. Now, that is a really weird ability. I don't know why you would want your item to not work, so we'll never use that one. But the third one, and it's the one that I really want to use, is the No Guard. It says every move used by or against this Pokemon will always hit. Now, you know, it's a double-edged sword for sure, but I will mention one attack that this will be like very useful for. But before we go into the attack, let's go ahead and go over the stats. Now for the HP, this Pokemon has 89. For the attack, he has 124, which is amazing. For the defense, it's gonna be 80. For the special attack, 55. For the special defense, 80. And for the speed, 55. So yes, Golurk is very, very slow, but perhaps with the Tailwind from the Nova, we can go ahead and speed up the Golurk a little bit at least. All right, let's go over the moves. So move number one will be the Poltergeist. So it has a 110 base power and 90 accuracy. Now that is a very powerful move. The only negative thing is that it will fail if the target has no health item, which doesn't concern me because every Pokemon in competitive battles has an item. For the second staff move, it's gonna be the Earthquake, self-explanatory. For the move number four, it will either be the Ice Punch or the Stone Edge. We'll see. Move number three will be the Dynamic Punch, and this is the move that you know, I really want to use with the No Guard ability. So it has 100 base power, which is really good, and then if I do the Terra Fighting, the damage is just gonna go through the roof. And you know, with an attack instead of 124, oh my god, that's gonna be really strong. Normally it has an accuracy of 50, but with a No Guard ability, that's just gonna be 100 for sure. Now, the Dynamic Punch has a secondary effect, which is it has a 100% chance to confuse the target. Now, that is very, very powerful. Now, for the item with the Golurk, I might go for... let's see, perhaps an Assault Vest or a Life Orb. We'll try different variations and see which one works best. But for now, I think the Assault Vest sounds about right. And Golurk will, from the 16 points we have left, I think this guy is going to set us back 6 points. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the 10th draft of... Okay, guys, for the next draft of the El Paso Pokemon Club, we got a surprise Pokemon that I was, like, very... Like, I really wanted to draft him, but at the same time... So it was between Lapras or Alolan Persian, and I think for now I'm gonna stick to Alolan Persian for now. Now you might be wondering, okay, like why the Persian instead of the Lapras, you know, one of the Pokemon that can be like one of the fan favorites. And the reason why I bring the Persian is because he can be a really good defensive pivot. Now let's see, so he has two useful abilities. One, the Technician, which increases the base power by 1.5 of every move that has a regular base power of 60. So Any move that has 60 base power or less will be increased by 50%. Now, that can be really useful, but the second ability that I think I will always be using is the Fur Coat. So, this Pokemon's defense is doubled now. That is really powerful. So, instead of 60 base defense, he's going to have 120. Now, let's go for the stats. So, he has 60 HP, attack of 60, defense of 60 normally, but with the ability, it's 120. Special attack of 75, special defense of 65, and a speed of 115. Now, you must be thinking, whoa, like the attacks are just like super like low. Yes, it is. But the speed is 115, and the role of a Alolan Persian won't be to attack, but to support. And let me show you some of the support moves that Alolan Persian can use. Now, he will always be using the Parting Shot, which lowers both the attack and the special attack. And it also retreats the user. So basically, I will use this move to run away and decrease the attack stats of the Ursaluna. No, I'm sorry, not of the Ursaluna. I will decrease the attack and the special attack of my opponent's Pokemon, and then I can bring the Ursaluna Blood Moon or whatever Pokemon I think it's best. Another move is the knockoff to get rid of the items. I do have to be very careful with the knockoff though, because so I know that I have mentioned this move quite a lot, but remember that Golurk has the poltergeist, and that only works if my opponent is holding an item. So I gotta be really careful about bringing like a lot of Pokemon that have the knockoff. And another move is the taunt that can be really useful. It depends on the scenario. Another move is the switch. How do you pronounce this? The switch. Switcheroo. Yeah, the switcheroo. It will basically trade my item for my opponent's Pokemon item. Now that can be like really useful on different scenarios. But he can also be a special attacker because he does learn the Nasty Plot, which will double the special attack of the Alolan Persian. And then I can use moves such as the Dark Pulse, the Power Gem, or the Thunderbolt. And so yeah guys, that's it for the Persian. This guy is gonna set me back 5 points of the remaining 10, which means I only got 5 left. And for the last draft, I'm gonna pick my second Terra Captain. I do have the option to making the Alolan Persian a Terra Captain as well, but since I don't know if I still wanna keep him, I'm not gonna do that. Instead, I'm gonna go for the next Pokemon has a Terra Captain, which is a Pokemon that I have used before. So let's go ahead and go into that Pokemon. Alrighty then guys, so last but definitely not least is gonna be my last Terra Captain, none other than the powerful Typhlosion. I know, again with the Typhlosion, but hey, what can I do? Like, he's so good. So the Typhlosion, I think he's gonna be really useful, especially with the hidden ability, which is the Flash Fire. So this gives my Typhlosion immunity to the fire, and it's also gonna increase my fire type attacks by 50%. Which is really good in my opinion. So that's gonna be the ability that I will be bringing with the Typhlosion. Now for the stats, we have the HP of 78, attack of 84, defense of 78, special attack of 109, special defense of 85, and a speed of 100. And for the moves, it's like they're always going to be the same. The eruption, obviously, to hit hard. Fire blast, the focus blast as well, and the scorching sands. For the items, it will be the choice scarf, but if my opponent's team doesn't have like super fast Pokemon, I might consider bringing a choice specs. But we'll see. Like I mentioned, it's gonna depend on my opponent's team. And so Typhlosion is gonna cost me the remaining of my points. And yeah, so that means that I have used all my 120 points. And yeah, guys, so that said, the El Paso Pokemon Club is gonna take part in the Spear Pillar Draft Association with this 11 Pokemon. So do wish me good luck, because I will be facing some strong trainers, and I will be also like introducing you guys to the 8 teams that I will be facing, and we will also be, you know, making a tier list of those teams. But going back to my 11 Pokemon, let's go ahead and analyze everything about my current team, shall we? Alrighty, so in terms of speed, the Nova, the Kilowattrel, is the fastest Pokemon with 125. Next is the Persian, next the Enamorus, and then surprisingly the Tentacruel and the Typhlosion with 100 base speed. The engine is gonna have a 90 base speed, with the right behind him is the Dahisuian Samurott with 85, Dragonite with 80, the Alolan Sandslash with 65, Golurk with 55, and then the Ursaluna Blood Moon with 52. Alrighty then, now let's go ahead and analyze the type chart. So far, I do see a weakness with the rock against rock type Pokemon. So I have 4 weak to rock, that being the Kilowattrel, the Enamorus, the Typhlosion, and the Dragonite. That means that my opponent will try to exploit this and, you know, just set up a stealth rock. However, you know, I do have 2 rapid spinners, so that does not concern me. However, what is concerning is the weakness to ground. Take a look at this. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4 Pokemon weak to ground, and 3 Pokemon that are immune to it. I might be able to, well, actually the engine, I mean, he will remain weak to ground times 4, but with the air balloon, I'm gonna remove that at least for one turn. And so yeah, guys, this is the team I'm gonna be using for this season. At least for now, for the beginning, I'm thinking about making some changes to it. But as of right now, these 11 Pokemon are gonna be it. You know, as the season progresses, if I see that my opponents are dropping Pokemon, I might, you know, drop some of mine to pick up some other Pokemon. But yeah, guys, this is the end of the video. Thank you so much for sticking around, and wish me good luck. Take care, guys. See ya!